Assalamu alaikum rahmatullahi barakatuh, my brothers and sisters. My brothers and sisters, a very important topic I want to speak about is takabbur, arrogance and pride, and how this disease can lead to you becoming a kafir. Yes, it can lead to you becoming a kafir, my brothers and sisters. And I'll explain to you a bit why about that later on. My brothers and sisters, the very first sin committed, the very, very first sin Iblis committed was that he had takabbur and arrogance and envy in his heart for Adam. A lot of people are going to argue with me, say, nah, he refused to take Allah's orders by prostrating to Adam. That is correct, 110% correct. But my brothers and sisters, you need to look into this in depth. Before he refused Allah's order, because Allah knows what he's created. Allah knows the action of Iblis before he does anything. He knows everything, Allah. What's the first sin Iblis did? He had takabbur, he had arrogance, and he had envy in his heart. He had pride in his heart. He had arrogance in his heart. Before he refused, he had this characteristic. And then he refused. So the first sin was takabbur, was arrogance, was envy. Iblis had it before he refused to prostrate to Adam. So my brothers and sisters, arrogance, takabbur, and ego, and envy and pride is a characteristic from the shaitan. And unfortunately, we all have this disease, including myself. I'm humble enough to admit, even me, because I am just a servant of Allah. I am not perfect. I'm a sinner just like everyone else. My brothers and sisters, when it comes to this deen is perfect. We are not. This deen is 110% perfect. We are not. We are sinners, my brothers and sisters. But unfortunately now, especially at this time now, people are bending the deen. People are bending the deen to suit their lifestyle. People have takabbur and arrogance and ego and are arguing for the sake of argument. People are compromising the deen to suit them. People are bending the deen out of fear. My brothers and sisters, this deen, we have to be 110% on it. You follow the deen, follow 110%. Don't bend it, don't compromise it. If you don't want to follow the deen, if you got a problem with something in the deen, say, look, brother, I'm doing the wrong thing. This is what the deen says, and I'm doing the wrong thing. But don't say the deen is wrong and try to bend the deen your way to suit you. If you don't want to follow it, say, I don't want to follow. I'm doing the wrong thing. I'm doing haram. May Allah guide me, inshallah. But don't bend the deen to suit your lifestyle. It doesn't work that way. It does not work that way. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam states, as long as you hold on to my Quran and my Sunnah, you can never go astray. You will never go astray. But my brothers and sisters, we're not holding on to the Quran and Sunnah anymore. We're not following the deen 100% anymore. We're bending the deen, we're compromising our deen. I had a brother a couple of weeks ago, wa'uqsum billah, I'm not lying to you. And this brother's watching this video now. He messaged me and he said, brother, can you call me? I don't know this brother. I don't know, I'm from a bar of soap. Khair, inshallah, kul shi bil khair bil salam. Because normally when I get messages, brothers got problems in their lives. They need some guidance, they need some advice. So I called this brother. Assalamu alaikum, because alaikum assalam, brother. Wallah, brother, I watch all your videos. This is what he said to me. I watch all your videos, brother, mashallah. And tabarakallah, wallahi, I love all your videos. But brother, I'm hesitant. I go, what are you hesitant for? You guys, for this past week, I'm at war with myself. I don't know whether to tell you or not to tell you. Because I'm scared. If I tell you, brother, you might get cut. I go, brother, tell me, khair, what is it? He goes, brother, one of the videos you made, you mentioned a verse in the Quran, and you didn't say it 100% correct. And straight away, he goes, please, brother, don't take it the wrong way. I go, listen, brother, I know which video you're talking about, and I've acknowledged it, and you're 110% right. And jazakallah khair for letting me know. He goes, wallah, brother, I didn't want to let you know. I didn't want your dramas, this, that. I didn't want you to get cut. I go, brother, no, do me a favor. When someone's doing something against the deen, when someone's doing something wrong in the deen, you have to let them know. It's your duty as a Muslim to let them know. My brothers and sisters, the only people that get cut, the only people that get angry, is the ones that get their ego bruised, is the ones that have ego and takabbur. I said to this brother, jazakallah khairan, do me a favor, brother, please. And he can verify, this brother can verify, he's watching this video now, inshallah. I said, do me a favor, brother. If someone's doing something wrong in the deen, if someone says something wrong in the deen, you have to correct. And don't worry about them getting cut with their ego and pride. That's a problem they have. That's their own problem they have. That's something they need to work on themselves. I was humble enough to admit when I'm wrong. My brothers and sisters, we all need to be humble enough to admit when we're wrong. Because if you're not humble enough to admit when you're wrong, it's going to lead to your kufr. And I'll get to this point now. If a brother sins, and sins and sins and sins. First time he repents, second time he repents, third time he repents. But if he keeps sinning, alright, because in our nature continue to sin, and if it's a big sin, eventually he will make a way for that sin to not look as bad, because he's no longer guilty. He doesn't feel guilty for that sin anymore. Why? Because he's no longer repenting anymore. Why? Because now he's said to himself, this sin is not a big deal because of this, and he's made an excuse for himself. That big sin doesn't become a big deal for him anymore. The guilt is not there anymore, and he has takabbur, and he has a big ego, and he's got arrogance in his heart. And if you tell him, brother, you're doing haram, he's got an excuse. He's justified his sin. And there's a lot of brothers and sisters that do that. They do big sins and they justify it. It's even to the point where brothers don't pray. I go, "Akhi, how come you don't pray, brother?" "Brother, go look at this sheikh. He's corrupt. Brother, go look at this jama'ah. They're corrupt. Brother, go look at this. Go look at that." Ya habibi, ya ayuni. Tomorrow Allah's going to question you. You're going to get your deeds in your hand. You're going to get a book in your hand. Allah's going to question you. How come you don't pray? He's not asking you about the sheikh. He's not asking about the jama'ah. He's not asking about anything else. He's not asking for your excuses. He's asking, what's your reason for not praying? What are you going to say, my brother? My brother, be humble enough. And don't have takabbur in your heart. When you sin, repent. Allah promises in the Quran. I'm not going to give you a hadith so someone can say to me it's weak hadith. In the Quran, Allah says, as long as my servant keeps repenting, I will forgive him. Not only that, look at the rahmah of Allah. Allahu Akbar. Look at the rahmah of Allah. And if he repents, I will turn his bad sins to good deeds. La ilaha illallah. And if he does a good deed, I will multiply it by 10. And if he sins, I'll only count it as one sin. But if he repents, I'll get rid of that sin and I'll turn it into a good deed. Look at the rahmah of your creator. Look at the rahmah of Allah. So my brothers and sisters, as long as you repent, Allah will forgive you. He won't even count that bad deed in your book. He won't even put it in your book of deeds. And he will turn it into a good deed. And for every good deed, it will times that up to 10 and more. Look at the rahmah and the mercy of Allah. But my brother and sister, if you're arrogant, if you got takabbur, if you got excuses and you're justifying all your sins all the time, you're not going to make tawbah. And if you don't make tawbah, and if you don't repent, then eventually you're going to be led astray. The shaitan's going to whisper in your head constantly, and it's going to lead you astray. Because the key here to stay on this deen is repentance. Because we are sinners. I'm a sinner too. We are all sinners. But if I stop repenting, if I stop asking for Allah's forgiveness, eventually I'm going to fall off the deen. Eventually, I'm not going to follow the deen properly. Eventually, it's going to lead me astray. So please, my brothers and sisters, it's very important. Humble yourself when it comes to the deen. If you're doing something haram, if you're doing something wrong, be a zalami, be a woman, own up to it. I have done wrong, Ya Rab, forgive me. Don't have pride, don't have takabbur, don't have the arrogance of the shaitan. I ask Allah to get rid of this arrogance, this pride and this ego that we all have, and to forgive us and to guide us all to the straight path. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.